There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus at night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that you're a teacher come from God, for no man can do these miracles you do, except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, Truly, truly, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus answered and said, How can these things be? Must a man enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered and said, Truly, truly, I say unto you, except a man is born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not, but I said unto you, you must be born again. The wind blows where it wishes, and you hear the sound of it, but cannot tell where it comes from or where it goes. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said, How can these things be? Jesus answered and said unto him, Are you the teacher of Israel, and you don't know these things? Truly, truly, I say unto you, we speak what we do know, and testify to what we have seen, and you receive not our witness. If I've told you of earthly things, and you do not believe, how shall you believe if I tell you of heavenly things? And no man has ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man, which is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world, through him, might be saved. He that believes on him is not condemned, but he that believes not is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light has come into the world, and men loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that does evil hates the light, neither comes to the light, lest his deeds should be exposed. But he that does the truth comes to the light. Jesus says, I am the light of the world. I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness. Are we following him? Are we following his words? I mean, this was the message that he spoke to Matthew as he called him from the tax office. Follow me. Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. Follow me. This was the message to Matthew and all the apostles. You know, Matthew saw the amazing catch of fishes that they brought in. And he really had no choice but to fall down on his knees and confess that he's a sinful man. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. There is no works to him that worketh not, but believeth on him that justifieth the ungodly. This sidewalk?
On this sidewalk over here.
Why not over here?
On this sidewalk over here.
Well, I can go that way, right?
Keep walking up.
Yeah.
But to him that worketh not, but believeth on him that justifieth the ungodly. You see, to him that worketh is the reward not counted as grace, but of debt. And it is by grace that we are saved, through faith. That, not of ourselves, it is the gift of God. It's grace. It's grace. But to him that works, it is by the blood. It is by the blood. Do you believe? I mean, one of the most familiar scriptures. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Do you believe? Do you have a faith like this? The scripture says, he who has believed has the witness in himself. Do you have the witness in yourself? The scriptures, breathed from the mouth of God, say, hereby we do know that we do know him in 1 John, by the Spirit which he has given us. By the Spirit. In Romans 8, it says, we've not received the spirit of bondage again to fear. Bondage, I mean slavery. We've not received the spirit of bondage again, but we've received the spirit of adoption. You see, there's one of two things we could be. A slave to sin, a slave to Satan, or we can be a servant of God. You see, we are debtors, the scripture says. Debtors to God. Wherein is freedom? Jesus says, he that commits sin is a slave of sin. The slave does not abide in the house forever, but the Son abides forever. If the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Ask yourself why you're discomforted with these words. They're breathed from the mouth of God. Are we not here to worship God? Are we not here to worship God? Yet Jesus says, why do you not understand my speech? Even because you cannot hear my word. You are of your father, the devil, and the lusts of your father you will do. He said, if you were of God, if God were your father, you would love me. For I proceeded forth and came from God. Is the word of God a passion for you? For some, maybe. The passion won't justify you, but it's evidence of justification. You see, if any man is in Christ, he is a new creation. He is a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. All things are of God. Are you a new creature? Have you even realized the old creature is not satisfactory? You see, we're born in trespasses and sins, dead. Born dead. Do you think he said in vain? Of all the trees in the garden, you may eat freely, but the tree that is in the center of the garden, you may not eat. In the day that you eat of it, you will surely die. And make no mistake, friends, they ate. And in the day that they ate of it, they surely died. This is why in Ephesians chapter 2 it says, and you has he made alive who were dead in trespasses and sins. We read in John 11, as Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. You know, he left them there 4 days. 4 days that the glory of God might be shown in him. There was a man who was blind from birth. And they came to him and said, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? And Jesus said, neither did this man or his parents, but that the works of God should be revealed in him. Lived his whole life blind, just so he could be healed by Jesus. Have his eyes opened. But he's come into the world, that those that see might be made blind, and to give sight to the blind. So the Pharisees said, are we blind also? He said, if you were blind, you would have no sin. But now you say we see. You see, if you think you're going to enter the kingdom of God by your own power, you've yet to know the power of his resurrection, because you must be raised up. Lazarus, come forth. Lazarus, come forth. You must be raised up. You must know the power of his resurrection. You must be made new. Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. In 1 John chapter 3, now this might sound harsh, but God says, whosoever is born of God does not commit sin. For his seed remains in him, and he cannot sin, because he is born of God. Because he is born of God. It's funny, huh? The word of God. If any man is in Christ, he is a new creation. It says every man that has this hope in him purifies himself, even as he is pure. So ask yourself, do you have this hope in him? Are you pure? Are you purifying yourself? Do you have this hope in him? The scripture says every man that has this hope in him purifies himself, even as he is pure. Or are you hopeless? Are you hopeless? Come to Jesus Christ and be healed. Know the power of his resurrection. Know the peace of God. Know peace with God. Tribulation and anguish upon every soul of man that sins. Isn't it hard to kick against the goats? Isn't it hard? It's interesting, we come here to worship God and laugh at the word of God being proclaimed. Laugh. It's funny. What religion do you follow? Turn to the word of God. Turn and be healed. Look unto me, all the ends of the earth, and be ye saved, saith the Lord. Look unto me. Let your heart break. Humble yourselves. Humble yourselves before the mighty hand of God, that he might raise you up. We must be raised up with Christ. We must be crucified with Christ. Those that are Christ's have crucified the flesh with its lusts. Are you crucified with Christ? Are you, better yet, raised with Christ? Have you been made alive? Have you been born of God? Except a man is born of God, he cannot see the kingdom of God. You will die in your sins unless you are born of God. Unless you are born of God, unless you are regenerated by the washing of the word. Do you have faith? Do you have faith? The demons believe there's one God. They tremble. Do you tremble before the word of God? You know, as it is written, you know, to this one will I look, to him that trembles at my word.
I can't hear.
It's his word. Do you have the fear of God ruling in your heart? Is obedience to him your passion? Have you had your heart changed? Have you had the heart of stone removed from your chest? If you don't know what that means, I fear for you. I fear for you. Cry out to Jesus Christ of Nazareth to have mercy on you. Confess your sins. Confess your sins before him and be healed.
I had the feeling that I wanted to hit somebody.
Woe unto you. Woe unto you that laugh now. You shall mourn. Come and be healed. You know, he that hates his brother is a murderer, and you know no murderer has eternal life living in him. Do you have eternal life living in you? Jesus says, why do you not understand my speech, even because you cannot hear my word? If God were your father, you would love me. Oh, but they tell you, aren't we all children of God? It's not what the scriptures say, friends. The scriptures say there is children of the wicked one, and there is children of God. There's no middle ground. We are either servants and slaves of Satan and sin. Are you still enslaved to your sin? In John chapter 8, read it when you go home. John chapter 8. He that commits sin is a slave of sin. And the slave does not abide in the house forever. Abide means live. The slave does not live in the house forever. Have you been set free? Have you been set free, or are you still enslaved? Know that freedom is found here in this blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Healing is here. He's come to proclaim liberty to the captives. Freedom. Freedom. Come and know this freedom. Come and know this peace. Come and know the power. The power of the blood of Christ, this Lamb. As he says, look unto me. Look unto me, all the ends of the earth, and be ye saved. The author and finisher of our faith. The author and finisher of our faith. Does the preaching of the gospel cause you to laugh? The preaching of the gospel calls you to laugh. It's interesting. It's interesting when the word of God can have that effect on Christians, right? Christians? Is this the Christian church? Does your church love the word of God? Come and be healed. You know, the carnal mind is not subject to the law of God. Neither indeed can it be. So that those that are in the flesh cannot please God. The natural man is at enmity with God. Enmity. It's only through the blood of Jesus Christ that we can be reconciled. And you must be reconciled. Can't you hear the Spirit of God pleading with you? Repent of your sins. Come and be ye reconciled to God. Come and turn to the Word of God. Jesus says, if you continue in my word, then you are my disciples indeed, and you shall know the truth. You shall know it, and the truth shall make you free. Freedom. It's beautiful. The opposite is slavery. Continue in your slavery if that's what you want. If the word of God is a joke to you. What God do you serve? Are you serving religion? That you laugh at the word of God, the words of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The one true God, the only God. He's the one who said you're slaves, not me. That's John chapter 8. But he said, if the Son sets you free, you shall be free indeed. You know, they wanted to stone him to death when he said that. Because they believed themselves children of God. That was their argument. We are children of Abraham. We've never been enslaved. Jesus said, most assuredly, I say unto you, he that commits sin is the slave of sin. And the slave does not abide in the house forever. They wanted to stone God to death when he said that. But he said, in me, there's freedom. Come and have freedom. Come and be set free. The freedom exists. You know, Jesus says, in my house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. But I go to prepare a place for you. He that has my commandments and keeps them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loves me will be loved of my Father, and we will come to him and make our home with him. He says, I will manifest myself to him. Manifest. Has the Son been revealed to you? Has the Son been revealed? Do you know what that means? Have you known the Spirit of God living within, the power of God to convert a man hopelessly lost? Convert them. Make them new. If any man is in Christ, he is a new creature. Have you been made new? Have you been made whole? Come to the feet of Jesus Christ. Come to the foot of the cross. Weep for your sins. Cry out to him. Jesus, have mercy on me. Jesus, thou Son of David, have mercy on me. Cry out to him. Come to the foot of the cross. Come and be healed. Come and be set free. Liberty. Freedom. And you must be set free. You see, the wages of sin is death. The wages of sin is death. Death is required. You see, as Abraham was told to sacrifice his only son. It's beautiful. The name of that mountain is called the Lord will provide the sacrifice. The Lord will provide. The Lord will provide. Jesus, behold, the Lamb of God. The Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. No man can take your sins away. Make no mistake, no work you do can remove your sins committed. You must be born again to see the kingdom of God. You must be washed. You know, unless the Lord sees the blood of the Lamb over your doorposts, you will suffer the wrath of God. You will suffer the wrath of God. Come and be healed. Flee from the wrath to come. Come. Behold the Lamb of God. Look on the Lamb of God. Do we have our Bibles? Let's look at 1 John chapter 3. Behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed on us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world does not know us, because it did not know him. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And every man that has this hope in him purifies himself, even as he is pure. Whosoever commits sin transgresses also the law. For sin is the transgression of the law. And you know that he was manifested to take away our sins, and in him is no sin. Whosoever sins has not seen him, neither known him. Little children, let no man deceive you. Do you know why God breathed this? Little children, who is he addressing? He's addressing the children of God. Little children, let no man deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that committeth sin is of the devil. For the devil sins from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested. For this purpose. For this very reason, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Whosoever is born of God does not commit sin. For his seed remains in him, and he cannot sin because he is born of God. In this, the children of God are manifested, they're revealed. And the children of the devil, whosoever doeth not righteousness is not of God, neither he that loveth not his brother. That's 1 John chapter 3. Do you laugh at that? Do you laugh at the word of God? What religion do you have? What religion do you have that does not love the word of God?
Why wouldn't guys be falling out of the trees?
It's okay. It doesn't matter what religion you join yourself to. There's only one God, one mediator between man and God, the man Jesus Christ. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. It's okay. You can laugh at his words and think yourselves Christians. But come to Jesus and be healed. Come and be healed. Have you known the power of his healing? Touch. As many as have touched the hem of his garment were made perfectly whole. Have you been made whole? Like Jesus said, do you want to be made whole? Do you want to be made whole? Or do you not yet know that you're poor and that you're blind and that you're naked? Jesus says, I counsel to you to come and buy from me gold tried in the fire, that you may be rich, and white raiment, that you may be clothed, lest you walk naked. And anoint your eyes with eye salve, that thou mayest see. Jesus came to give sight to the blind, to give sight. Come and be washed in the word of God. I say we have our tradition, you have your Bible, but we all have the Bible now. There was times of ignorance, you know, God once winked at, but now he commandeth all men everywhere to repent. You see the reaction to the word of God? You see the hatred for it amongst the crowds? It's amazing.